Dear students, welcome to my session. I am Ravi Kumar KR, lecturer in Computer Science, JSI PU College, Mysore. Students, in my previous session, I have explained to you about member functions and the member functions, how it can be defined. And as I told you already in a previous session, there are two methods of defining a member function. One is, in first method, the function definition inside class, and second method, a function definition outside a class. This one I have explained to you with two examples. And in this session today, I am going to talk about one more concept, that is array as a member of a class. Array as a member of a class, member of a class. Students, you know how to define a class. For example, if I say class add, and here data variables under private int x comma y, and under public void get data, one function, and one more function is void display, and again we are closing the class here with a semicolon. This is, you know what is a class. This class, class name is add is a class name, and this is data members, and this is member methods or functions. And what is the meaning of this array as a member of a class? In this example, we have declared x and y are data members, as data members, you know it. But if I declare in the place of this, if I declare an array, that is the meaning of array as a member of a class. For example, in the place of this, if I write here int m of 5 and semicolon. Now, you know what is an array last year. What is an array? Array is a group of elements of similar data types and under one name. That is, in this example, m is an array, and this is an array index. See, this is subscript of an array. So what's the meaning of this? So this is, if I say int m of 5, we have declared an array as a member of a class. So this is the meaning of the heading array as a member of a class. Then how do we proceed from here onwards? This is, as usual, we have to write a program based on an array. Now, let me explain the same program with one example. A program to read marks of 5 students and print. So this is an example program for array as a member of a class. And let us start a program as usual, students. First, we start with header file, hash include iostream.h, hash include conio.h, and let us declare a class here. I say class student, it's the name of a class. Under this, we had to define an array, isn't it? So here, under private access specifier, let us declare an array int m of 5. This is an array, and along with this, I have to use one more variable I. This is for loop control variable. And under public under public, let us define two functions, that is void getData is one function, semicolon, and one more function, void display. Void display, and here we are closing the bracket along with a semicolon. Student, as a first step here, header files. First step is, next is defining a class. Class name is student, and here under this private specifier, we have defined an array. That is array as a member of a class. In this example, m of an array, m is an array, so it is a member of a class student, and variable I here, and under public we have defined two. And you observe this, this is also an example for a function definition outside a class, because here only have declared two functions, getData and display, and for these functions we supposed to write function definition. As I already have closed the class here at this stage along with the semicolon, so function definition we have to write outside a class. Okay, now what is after this, what is the next step here? Now we have to start writing function definition for these two functions. Now let us define the functions for this. Students, you have learned in my last session or in last example, how do we access the data member or member function of a class? That is with the help of scope resolution operator. Now let us define the function definition for these two functions with the help of scope resolution operator. Now how do we do that? First we start with function. First one is void. What is the class name? Class name is student here. Void student, and here I am using scope resolution operator along with, what is the function name? First one is getData. Is getData, and here no semicolon, please observe that. And here we have to write the function definition. So this program is nothing but a program and single dimensional array to accept the marks of 5 students and have to print the same. So as a first step here, you know, all of you, we have to use, we are using loop here, for loop. So first step is cout, enter marks, and here we are using for loop. So how do we use it here? For I, this is where, that is why I have declared variable here. This is a loop control variable. For I is equal to 0, semicolon, I less than 5. Why less than 5? Maximum size of an array is 5. So this is less than 5, and here I plus plus. And under this, I am going to write here C in statement here. C in. What is name of an array? Name of an array is M. So it is M, and the index I'm going to write I and semicolon. I'm closing this for loop as well as this function. So this is one function. To have defined this outside a class. So this is a function for function definition of getData function. Similarly, now we have to write one more function of void display. Okay, let me write here itself. So here, next function, we start with void student is name of a class with the operator, and function name is display and no semicolon. And here we are supposed to write the statements. Here first one is, I say cout marks of a student. Student, I say endl semicolon, and after this I have to use again for loop. Already have learned last year, for I equals to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus, and here output statement is cout. I say cout, what is the name of an array here? M. I say M of I, and here we can make use of this to give space in between and semicolon. Then after this, I am closing this for loop as well as this function. So this is void student name of the class display is a function. This is function definition. So this is a function definition to display the marks of a student. So what is the final? Now, as all of you know this, this is in, still the program is incomplete because we have to write main function. So after this, let us write main function here. Main function void main. Under this, clear screen. Next, already I have told you in my previous sessions, first step inside main function is to create an object of a class. Here, name of the class is student. How do we do that? Student is name of a class, and here I say yes. Yes is an object. I have given user defined name, variable, yes. And how do we invoke, how do we call the functions here? With the help of operator dot. So yes dot, yes is an object, dot is an operator. And first function is get data. First function is get data and semicolon. And second function is yes dot display semicolon. So after this, normally we close with get ch and close it. So student, this is a complete program to work with an array. It is an array program, and it is to read marks of 5 students and print the same. And this is also an example for an array as a member of a class. Observe this. In the inside a class, under private data access specifier, we have defined an array M of 5. So this is an example for array as a member of a class. Students, next concept is array of objects. Students, in our previous example, I have written a program based on array to enter a marks and to enter marks of one student and print a marks of one student. So here, what is the meaning of array of objects? Here, in the previous example, we have created only one object of a class. For example, student, yes, isn't it? Just observe that. Observe the previous example. We have written student, yes, in the main function. So yes is only one object. Suppose, what is the meaning of array of object here? Suppose if you create an array as an object, if you create an array as an object, so that is the meaning of here, array of object. Now let us look at the example here. For example, okay, students, class student, under this, variables, under private access specifier, I say int, roll number, comma, marks 1 and marks 2, semicolon. And under public, if I declare two functions here, void get data is one function. Similarly, void display, second function. I am closing this function with the semicolon. Now what is the next step here? As all of you know that, after this we have to write the function definition outside the class, and after that, under main function, we have to create an object of a class. Now let me write the main function. Under main function, void main, normally we'll start with clear screen. After this, first, next step is to create an object of a class. Now, how do we do that? In this example, student is name of a class, and here In previous example, we have written only S here. So what is the meaning of this? There is only one object of a class student. Suppose if I say array of objects, array of objects. What is the meaning of this? Suppose if I in the place of this, if I write here S of 3. So what is the meaning of this now? So this is the meaning of array of objects. Here student S of 3. Here S of 3 is an object, but what is S? S is an object. What is the meaning of S of 3? But S is an array here. S is an array. So what is the meaning of this? If you observe this, actually in this all of you know this size is 3. And if the size is 3, this starts with S is name of an array. Under this, there are 3 elements. Index is 0, 1, 2. So if I say S of 3, 3 elements. So this S of 3, it consists of 3 values or these data of 3 students. So I repeat once again, the meaning of this S of 3 is nothing but this is an array. So array holds 3 values. So how do we imagine array? Array we imagine like this. S is the name of an array. These are the 3 size of the array is 3. There are 3 elements here. Under each element, it stores the values of one student. For one student, it takes the roll number, marks 1, marks 2. And see, it takes roll number M1, M2. This is for one student at the index 0. Similarly, again here, roll number M1, M2. It is for second student. And it is again, if I say roll number M1, M2, this is for second student, for third student. So see, this is the meaning of array of objects. Array of objects. So now let us write a simple program to understand how do we use this array object in a program, or what is an array of objects. Plus you understand that in my look at this example here, this is a class. In the main, we have to create an object of a class under main function. In this example, if I write here student S of 3, if I write here student S of 3, what this is an array here. So that is the meaning of array of objects. So this object, it is not one object. One object of an array, it consists of 3. In this example, 3 is the size of an array. It consists of 3 elements or 3 elements. In each element, it consists of all the data of one class. The data of one class here. So in index 1, it consists of or it contains the details of second student. And under index 2, it contains the student of third student here, student number 3 or third student information. So this is the concept array of object. Now let me write a simple program to show how to work with array of objects. We'll start with header file. iostream.hash. Hash include conio.hash. Define a class. Class student, variables under private int roll number comma M1 and M2, and under public we write 2 functions, void get data and void display, close the class along with semicolon. Now let us write function definition of these two classes. function definition of these two classes. As usual, void, name of the class is student, two colons, function is getData, and here we have to accept the values of three variables. Cout, enter roll number m1 and m2, and here cin variable is roll number, next variable is m1 and m2, semicolon, closing this function. This is the function. What is the next function? Next function, I have to write display, function definition of display. I say void student is the name of the class, colon, here function name is display. Here we are supposed to display the details, roll number, marks 1 and marks 2. We can write like this. Cout name equals, roll number equals variable roll number endl. Similarly, cout marks 1 equals, close the quote with m1 endl. Cout marks 2, close the quote, m2 is the variable endl. After this, we have to close the function void display. So first we have started the program with the header files, definition of a class, function definition. So next step is to create an object of a class and have to call the functions one by one. So here we'll start with void main. First step is clear screen. Next, we have to create an object of a class. Name of the class is student. I say S of 3. After creation of object here, S3. S3 is name of an object with the concept array of object. Next, we have to call this, or we have to call the functions, these functions in the order one by one. That has to, because it is an array, it has to be done, or it has to be called inside for loop. So we start with the for loop. For int I equal to 0, I less than 3, and I plus plus. And here we have to call the function one by one. How do we call the function? Here first is array, is name of an array is yes. So I say yes, name of an array, and for first index it starts with 0. So we say S of I. This is S of I is the, yes is the name of an array, I is the index. So here dot get data. Now observe this. So this is how we are using. So with the help of index, it takes three values, get data. Now after this, I am closing this for loop here. Students, after reading the data of three students, next we are using one more loop to print the values of, or to make use of this function display. So after this, I say here for int I equal to 0, I less than 3, I plus plus, and here I say s of I dot s of I dot put display. Display is name of a function. Display semicolon. I am closing this for loop here. Closing the for loop. After this, I am closing this main function. So this is a simple program to understand the concept of array of object here. In this example, you have to observe here the main function. In previous examples, we used to create only one object like s, but in this example, s of 3, here array. With the help of, we have created an object with the help of an array. Array means number of elements. S of 3 stands for this array consists of 3 elements. Size is 3. And how do we access the data elements of an array? With the help of for loop. And in this example, s of I means I stands for 0, means for first student. So control from here, it goes to, comes here, it goes to the function get data. The control transfer from here to this point, it reads with the help of get data. With the help of this function, it takes the values of one student. Immediately after that, for second student and third student. After this, we are using one more for loop here to access or to print. To print, we have to invoke or we have to call the function display. How do we do that? With the help of again for loop. With the help of for loop, we have to, how we are calling this? Again, s of I dot display. So s of i in the sense, first index is 0. So the value stored in the index of array 0 is going to print with the help of a function, because the statement you have written here, student display, to print name, sorry, roll number, m1, marks of one subject and marks of second subject. So this is an example to show the working of, or how to work with, array of objects. Students, hope you have understood the concept and you can get back to us for any of your doubts. I will come back to you with my next session. Thank you very much.